UFC heavyweight division collision.
Right. Then he goes back to find another big strike. He does not waste energy just throwing little rabbit punches. Everything has to matter, as you've seen in some of the great grounded pound fighters you've ever seen, like Jack Hermanson, the guy that beats you into the bottom of the octagon until you roll over and give up your neck to get submitted.
Yeah, nothing pitter-patter about it.
No.
All right, so here he is, a man who needs no introduction, the former K-1 World Grand Prix champion, heavyweight contender, Alistair Overeem. Kind of surprised you haven't shared the octagon with this guy yet.
Yes, we have seen Alistair Overeem for a really long time. We've seen the ups, we've seen the downs. From the highest of highs as a strike force heavyweight champ to the lowest of lows, he's been here and he's been around forever. But the one thing that you know when you think about Alistair Overeem is that when things get tough, he will evolve. He will get better. And recently, he has been back on the upswing in his career.
Or till the date for this, our main event of the evening. Overeem is 3 years his senior. The rest is nearly identical. And now for the official introductions, the veteran voice of the Octagon is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Yves Levine. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out arena in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a wrestler, holding a professional record of 5 wins, 3 losses. He stands 6'3" tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Fighting out of Regina, Saskatchewan, Canada. Ladies and gentlemen, he is a former UFC heavyweight champion, Lesnar! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 47 wins, 18 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 6'4" tall, weighing in at 260 pounds. Fighting out of Amsterdam, the Netherlands, Alistair Overeem!
Okay, protect yourself at all time will be my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now, go back to your corner.
They touch him up and we are underway. All right, so the fight is now underway. On one side, you have a fighter who does everything well, taking on a true grappler on the other side. Going to be interesting to see how long he can keep it up.
I mean, Damian Maia may be the most specialist type of grappler in the UFC. This guy resembles him in a number of ways. Let's see how he manages this fight against a guy that can do just about everything inside the octagon.
Now he gets a more dominant position with the underhook.
He is going to start to drop.
Quick level change.
Oh, he went single. Rotate here outside. This dude's going for a ride.
Oh.
Nice big takedown. What a technique. What a takedown. Great high impact skill.
You could feel the canvas reverberating here. The
I mean, right there. Boom, 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 boom. It's like me running anywhere, John.
Just out of range with that left hook. All right, single collar tie now.
Nice punch, man. Over the top. check these low leg kicks. Nice body kick right under the elbow.
Oh, knee strike right to the bottom. And he comes through with a big knee. Oh! So just over 20 total strikes have now found the target for Alistair Overeem.
Big power punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
He's a tough takedown. There you go.
Overeem gets back up again. Oh, single collar tie here.
Big knee lands to the body. Beautiful leg kick for him.
Oh, man, this guy kicks like a mule.
So hard. He kicks so hard. Every time you can see him drive his shin into his opponent.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. Good series of kicks by him there, DC. He certainly has that part of his game going tonight.
He's a fantastic kickboxer, but tonight is the kicks that lead the dance.
Well, good news, bad news, right? The strike there lands, but just not much steam on it because his gas tank seems to be on the verge of empty.
The gas tank is completely empty. All that butt mashing is no good. You wasted your energy. You wasted your time. Now it's just a matter of when your opponent decides to finish. Nice.
With the straight hand there. Nice job by the ring. Final seconds of round one. Oh, I love the jab. I know you love the jab. That was a nice one.
It's my favorite punch in all the fight.
You gotta be careful dipping his head when he's throwing that jab.
Boom, body kick right there. Landed perfect.
All right, a lot of high-level striking action in that last round. Daniel, take us through it, if you will.
Tit for tat. Who has the best chin? It seemed as though they were looking for that answer. Both guys took risks. What a fantastic round.
All right, next round is underway, DC. We talked about his powerful kicks, how he attacks all sides of the body, the head, the legs. Pretty good shot.
That was so impressive to see.
Shot there, DC. He is officially rocked.
A big, that really has put his opponent on skates. You can't take many of those, you better check.
Oh, what a shot to the body. He told us he was going to achieve.
Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished. It does not get much better than that. Look at how fast. The only person I can do this to is maybe John. John, there's a weight difference. I don't know if you know jiu-jitsu much. A lot of your classes. If I'm gonna do this to anybody, it's Anik.
Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combinations.
It's because he's not committing to it fully. He throws his jab. He may float a right hand out there, but he's not really sitting down on the right hand. He really doesn't seem to have the intent on landing it. He's gotta be confident that it's going to land, and he's gotta really throw his whole time.
Job to get the head kick home, and now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. High, and now he's got hurt bad.
Nice defense there. Huge block. Now a knee. Oh, big left hook there. Yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Now goes in and secures the takedown.
You heard him in the last round. Same exact one.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie. Oh, continuing to soften up the target here. Nice knees to the body. Oh, the kickboxing chops on full display with that offering. Nice knees. Oh, just digs his body.
He's been shot through every part of himself, and now he's got his opponent hurt.
Oh! Kick right under that right elbow. Change that.
He went single into a high cross. He's taking his dude for a ride.
Under a minute now to go.
Unbelievable. That shot landed perfectly, and now he's got his opponent hurt.
He blocked the shot. 30 seconds to go in round two. 20 seconds left. Overeem gets caught with that punch. Got to shore up the defense here. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie. And that's the end of round number two. All right, there's the end of the round. We'll show you some of the highlights. It must feel pretty damn good to knock a man down like that.
It feels good to knock a man down. And most times, you don't even feel it. It's the ones that you don't even recognize that landed hard are the ones that usually put your opponent out. It landed right on the sweet spot, and he hurt his opponent very badly.
All right, the action continues here and now as our next round gets underway. The previous round won't be confused for a round of the year, but pretty good action.
It was a pretty good...
Oh, a violent strike to the body. This could be the end of
this fight. It's both being stopped.
Trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now, he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head, or he's going to get blasted. His double leg shot.
Oh, slams his opponent to the ground. Oh, he's back up again. You got to like that. Overeem gets caught with that punch. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Well, the strike lands there, but doesn't do a ton of damage because the fighter's cooked.
Yeah, he's done. He's thrown everything with him with absolute power. And now it does not matter how many times you jam on that X button. It will not do any damage.
Oh, right under the
other. It was perfect.
Double leg shot.
Oh, how about the slam there? That one cannot feel good. Back to the feet. Ain't much. Beautiful land there by Alistair Overeem. Continues to cross train at different places. Finished up. Oh, what a shot to the body. His opponent
trying to keep his poker face, but he's hurt very, very bad.
Well, he has certainly kept the punch counters busy tonight. He's landed a ton of significant. Oh man, look what that one body shot did.
That shows the power and the placement. It was placed perfectly, and now he's got his opponent.
Unbelievable. Position here on the clinch. Both fighters trying to get a more dominant position. Oh, beautiful takedown by him there as he lands another one. He's keeping the stat guys busy tonight.
Huh? I mean, oh, now he has a headlock trying to pin his opponent's back down flat onto the mat. Look from the transition to an arm triangle to try to chase the finish.
Working hard, posting, and getting back up.
Go! What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish his fight.
Look, is there again. Oh! Liver kick! That'll do it!
He's done!
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught. He wanted to make sure he kept the judges out of the equation. Mission accomplished on that front as he gets the TKO victory here tonight. All right, we take a look back at the replay, and not every day you see a fight end due to a body kick like that.
That was a massive body kick, snuck it right under the elbow. Once it landed, you knew the fight was about to be finished.
So a big win for him here tonight, and an even bigger statement made by virtue of the TKO. Now we go inside the Octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
This contest at 4 minutes, 36 seconds of round number three. Declared the winner by TKO, Alistair Overeem.
Well, could you you imagine what the celebration is like in his hometown right now after he gets the TKO win tonight? He said he wanted to leave the judges out of it. Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished. He left the judges out of it. The judges could have went to the concession stand, because once he got his opponent hurt, he was not.